Hello everybody and welcome back again to Let's Play Assassin's Creed 3. Today we're starting in whatever this place is. It looks fancy. But yeah, before I leave, apparently there's someone I can talk to somewhere around here. Let's see if we can find that person. Is it even in here or is it... Yeah, I guess it's one of these guys. Well?
Still here, are you?
I was just wondering, what happens now?
There's quite a lot to do. Commander Washington must determine when and where we'll strike next. And we need to get to work on our message.
Message?
We must contact the broadsheets at once. Ensure it's clear to everyone that it was the Loyalists who fired first in Lexington.
But no one knows who fired first.
Which is exactly why we must spread the news quickly. We'll determine public opinion.
This seems dishonest.
Perhaps, but so what? People must believe we acted in self-defense, else we've committed treason.
But you have.
Better to bow and scrape before a tyrant, then? Is that what you suggest?
No, of course not. No one should be denied freedom. And yet, to change the truth, it seems a dangerous road to travel.
Understand, Connor. This is a war fought not just on the battlefield, but within hearts and minds as well. There's nothing wrong with a bit of theater, especially if it saves lives.
Well, I guess Connor does not agree with that. By the way, can I look around here? I mean, this seems to be a larger place. So maybe I should see if we can find anything else in here. Well, lots of fancy people. And Connor seems to be very out of place here. But I don't think I can talk to any of these guys. Nope. Alright, well, in that case, I think I'm going to leave. And then we decide what to do next. Okay, and now you just drop me off somewhere. I'm not even near that building anymore. Well, that's interesting. I guess I'm in the front here. Yes, I am. I'm not seeing any new missions in here. So maybe I'm just going back to Boston and take care of that liberation mission. That is still open. But why is... Oh, this is my next main mission. Right? Okay. But yeah, I think I would prefer to go back to Boston now. And take care of that one liberation mission, which is somewhere around here, I think. So let's fast travel to this spot. And I guess I'm going to recruit another assassin if I finish this mission, right? Let's see. Okay, it's somewhere around here. I suppose it's this guy. Martial Law.
Welcome to the regulars! The most feared, respected, and revered fighting force on God's green earth. Some of you are here by choice, others not. Regardless of the circumstances of your joining us, you are all brothers now. And the only way you have a chance of surviving is if you trust your brothers. One weak link can kill a whole squad on the field. I want you to think about that long and hard.
That's one of them that's responsible for this. Rounding up the young ones and shipping them off. We need to put an end to it.
What is your plan?
Kill him, then the rest, and set all them boys free?
It's a good plan, but it lacks detail.
Yeah.
How is your aim with that rifle?
can pop a muskrat's head from a quarter mile 9 times out of 10. And the 10's a misfire.
That should do. Cover me from up there.
All right. Kill the Templar leader. And I'm already in a restricted area. No, I'm not. I mean, these people would already be suspicious if I was. Okay, the Templar leader is on top of that battlement. So, I don't have any optional objectives or anything to that extent, which means I can just go right for my target. Oh, we have a lot of people over here. Well, I'm just interested in going after my target over here.
On that ship.
There we go. So,
we assassins strive for peace through freedom, and the Templars, they want only to control.
Well, I'm for freedom, I know that much.
This is all?
If your order needs a good rifle, sign me up.
Well, apparently that was all. I somehow expected that I would have to involve the guy with his gun, but apparently Connor managed to do this all on his own. Okay, which means I have a new guy to talk to now, I suppose. Oh, it's this guy. I think I actually saw him before, but I couldn't, like, talk to him. So, that was weird. But I'm going to assume that I can talk to him now. So, I will do that. And, I don't know, it might not be a bad idea to talk to my other assassins too. Maybe they have something new to say. We will find out. Alright, here he is. I think he moved from his previous place to the tavern. Let's talk to him.
You do not partake?
No, sir. I need to stay sharp in case you call upon my rifle. Spirits do me in right quick. Drank half a flask of rum out in the bush with my brothers a few years back. I went for a run in the buff before I found myself rolling around in deer scat being sick all over. I don't want to go there again. No, thank you.
Smart choice, given the circumstances.
I want to fight like you someday.
You have everything it takes to be a great assassin.
And that means something coming from you.
Well, I guess Connor is getting there. I mean, he's still very young and inexperienced, but I think he's getting there. And compared to these guys, I guess he's already a wise mentor.
Where did you learn to shoot like you do?
Ranging with my dad and brothers in Virginia country. My family's been surveying and prospecting out there since my grandpappy.
How did you end up here?
I'm the youngest of four brothers. I was always going to be a runner-up with them. So I set off alone to do my own business. Out west of Ohio's territory that no man of the colony's ever trodden. I figured I could find contracts out of New York. Then the war started.
And you sided with the Patriots?
Not really. My family's for the king. I just don't like seeing boys forced to fight against their will is all. But I know that I want to be free. For all to be free. If that means I'm a patriot, I guess I am.
You are an assassin. Nothing else.
That I am. I'm proud of it.
Well, I guess that's one way to look at it. Alright, I have exhausted his dialogue, so I'm going to leave again. No, I'm not going to play any games. I will probably just lose my money, and I don't have so much money. Yeah, I guess I will check in with my other assassins. Maybe they have new dialogue. And if they don't, I'm just going to look for any other interesting side missions. And if I don't have any, I'm going back to the main mission. Alright, I checked in with my other assassins, but they didn't have any new dialogue. I also checked the homestead to see if there's more homestead missions or new conversations, but again, there's nothing new. Because, I mean, I haven't finished a sequence, so I guess it only updates once I finish a sequence. So yeah, let's just go back to the main mission, which apparently starts right over here. Let's see.
Hold and state your business!
What I have to do. I just want to go to my next main mission. Can you please not shoot me? Conflict looms. Yes, I can see that.
I'm looking for Israel Putnam.
On whose orders?
Samuel Adams.
He looks very suspicious.
Follow me.
Okay, so where are we going?
This is not Bunker Hill.
Aye, it's Briggs. There's been some disagreement as to where we should encamp.
Any news from Boston?
The Tories aren't moving. And any time we try to press them, we lose a dozen men. I think Putnam and the others plan to assemble artillery on these hills. A good shelling might make the Redcoats rethink their strategy.
And what of John Pitcairn?
That bastard's the cagiest of the bunch. He's appeared time to time to taunt us or send regards by way of cannon fire. It's all right, though. He'll have what's coming to him soon enough.
Whoa, this is bright. And yes, I can hear the cannon fire. It almost sounds like distant thunder.
Putnam's just up ahead. You call me.
I don't care much for your excuses, gentlemen. We could be building on Bunker Hill. Reeves is closer to the city, but it is also closer to their artillery!
Our orders came from men so divorced from the situation, we are compelled by reason to employ our own faculties to make a proper determination.
Were that I could understand even half that nonsense you just uttered.
What's not to understand? I'm trying to ensure our victory!
Where would you know about victory? I killed a she-wolf in her den armed with only a knife! I saved the Kanawaga Indians who sought to burn me alive! And I was the sole survivor of a shipwreck during the Battle of Havana! So you will excuse me if I choose not to follow your advice.
That guy seems to be very angry.
I rest my case. I'm going back to Bunker Hill! Good day, gentlemen!
General Putnam.
What?
I am looking for John. I was told you would be able to help me find him.
He's tucked away inside that city with no reason to leave. As long as that ship continues its assault, we'll never flush him out.
But if the ship was silenced...
Oh, then poor John might be forced to get off his arse and come forward.
I shall fly this flag to signal my success.
And I shall speak fondly of you at your funeral.
Well, thank you. I also like how they just continue their conversation in the middle of the bombardment. Okay, go to the ships. Optional objective, cross Charlestown without taking damage. Okay, well... maybe I should start by not taking any fall damage. That would be a good start. Oh, and yeah, maybe I shouldn't get hit by any of the cannons either. Stay in motion to avoid being hit by incoming cannonballs. Alright. I can stay in motion. Oh, well, there's an invisible wall. Which is limiting my motions. Alright. But I guess I can run across these little backyards, huh? Well, can't go through here, it's all on fire. So, let's take it to the roof. Oh, now we have soldiers in the streets. Oh, I'm going to take fall damage. No, I did not. Huh. I was a little bit worried there for a moment. Okay, so I'm in the water now. I hope they don't fire on me while I'm in the water. Oh, there we go. I finished my objectives, but I got new ones. Let me take a look at this. Assassinate a grenadier. Remain undetected while on board of ships. Oh dear. Seems to be a difficult one. I have to go to that ship. Right. Let's try to enter it from a position where the guards are not watching. I mean, they all look towards the shore, I'm going to assume. So I will try to climb it from the other side, if there's a way up here, that is. Let's see. Can I climb any of this? Yes, I can. There's no way I'm going to stay undetected with all of these soldiers here. Honestly, I don't think this is going to work. Oh well, we already have some that are getting suspicious. I mean, if there were any soldiers that are close enough that I can secretly assassinate them. But I don't even see any of that. Let's have another quick look. Yeah. I mean, can I, like, call my own assassins to do this? I mean, if they get detected, it doesn't count as me being detected, right? So maybe I should do that. But I'm not sure if I can actually call them in this mission. Yeah, I don't think I can. I suppose that would be too easy. I have to do it by myself. Okay, let's start with these guys. Well, and I'm detected. Okay. That's going to make my life a lot easier, though, because now I can just fight them in the open. Alright. Let's see if I can get a kill streak going. Well, that was a short one anyway. Alright, you're dead, and I think that's all of them. Light the black powder in the ship's hold. Okay, let's do it. Oh, stand back, right. I probably should do that. There we go. I think that ship is sufficiently destroyed, but I still have to take the other ship. And I mean, since I failed my objective already, I may as well go straight for it and start killing these people. Oh, maybe I shouldn't climb it on this side because there's cannons. And the cannons are firing. Right. Let's see if we find a good spot to climb. Oh, hang on a second. I think I can maybe air assassinate one of these guys. That's another one of my objectives, right? Let's see. Oh, but I guess it wasn't the right person to assassinate. Oh! Look at the big guy over here. I And he's still not dead. Oh, now he's dead. Oh, I guess he is one of the guys I would have to air assassinate. Oh well. That's two more objectives that I completely failed. Alright, here we go. Let's plant the bomb. And let's stand back. Nice. The bombs are out of commission. All right, I still have to raise the flag. Do I have to do it on both ships or will one suffice? Let's see. Oh, can I not climb this way? Yeah, I suppose I can't actually climb up this way. I need to maybe use this over here. All right. Let's do it this way. Right, I still need to get higher. No, what are you doing, Connor? Don't do this. Don't scare me like this. Just climb this damn mast. Okay. Well, oh. I didn't expect him to do that. But I'm also not entirely sure how to get up here. I mean, he's taking cover behind it. But he's not really climbing this stuff. Come on, Connor. How hard can it be? Oh no! Why are you falling down? Why are you not climbing the mast? Connor, please. Work with me here. Oh, okay, I have to climb it from this angle. There we go. Swim back to the shore. Okay, I can do that. And that's a nice swan dive. And yes, I failed two of my objectives. Because I wasn't aware that the Scottish guys are the Grenadiers. I should have looked that up beforehand, maybe. Main objective, mount the horse. Is this already the next mission? I guess it is, but I mean it's right over here, so I think I should just continue with this. Well, there is a lot of destruction here. Look at this. So, where are we going exactly? Back to Putnam?
The enemy advances. Men tremble. They've better numbers, you say. Better weapons, better training. But I do not fear. And neither should you. For what they have in material They lack in conviction and care. But not us. We have discipline. We have order. And most importantly, we have passion. We believe. So maintain vigilance. Preserve your ammo. Ensure a proper line of sight. And above all else, men, do not fire until you see the whites of their eyes. I'll be damned. You did it.
That was quite a speech.
Lies, all of it, I'm afraid. Still, such words have carried us thus far.
And what of Pitcairn?
He's left Boston, as I said he would, and set up camp on Molten Hill. There's no good way to get at him. Not with that maelstrom brewing down below. I suppose you could circle around a bit, or wait for us to thin their ranks.
Okay.
There is no time. I will have to chance a direct approach.
That's twice today you've proposed the impossible.
I see no other choice.
Not because you're mad to march here, son.
I expect an apology on my return.
Okay. Okay, so what do I have to do now? Cross the battlefield. Cross the battlefield without taking damage. Okay. I guess this is my first destination. Let's go. Ooh. Use cover to avoid damage. Move from cover to cover between volleys. Okay. I'm not hearing any pause in firing though. It seems to be pretty much permanent. Well, maybe when I see all the fires over there, that's a volley, so I should run as soon as I fire. Okay, let's go. Again, let's watch the fires over here. There we go. Oh, Connor didn't want to leave cover. He kind of got stuck. Let's try this again. Okay, now we have fire and another cover over here. Okay, where would be the next cover? That one over there, maybe? Okay, let's watch for the fires. There we go. And run. Again, wait for the fire and run. Where exactly would be the next cover though? Not really seeing any cover, so maybe I just run for my destination over there? Okay, there we go. Okay, I made it. I made it. So, now I have to go somewhere over here. Oh, but I see, oh, a patrol over there. Can I hide somewhere here? Don't really want to run into these guys. I am hidden, right? Yes, I think I am hidden. Let's wait for them to pass. Okay. Oh, there's even more. Again, can you please hide in here? Oh, I think they're looking for me. I'm not here. Please move on. Maybe I should climb the trees. Are these guys going to stay here now, really? This is going to be a problem. I may have to fight these guys. Because they're not moving. Yeah, I guess I'll have to go into open combat and kill them. What if I whistle? Well, now I have to fight them one way or the other. But I mean, they were not going away. What else was I supposed to do? Alright, let's wait for them to attack so we can parry and then maybe get a killing streak going. And these big guys are a problem. Let's try to kill him first, if we can. Especially since they seem to be doing damage even if you block. That's a problem. And they're really hard to kill too. I mean, look at that. I blocked so many of his attacks and I'm still taking damage and he's still not dead. And now they killed me. Yeah, I should have avoided them, but I just was out of cover for like 2 seconds and then they saw me. And that was the end of it. And now they're just gone. Well, this is going to make my life easier, probably. Let's try to get on top of the trees this time. And I hope they're not going to see me here. Yes, I think this might be a better approach. Let's wait for them to pass. And there we go. Okay, this is working a lot better already. And that's probably how this mission is intended to work. Can I climb these rocks? Oh yeah, I can. There we go. Okay, hang on a second. My objectives updated. Assassinate John Pitcairn. Assassinate Pitcairn without being detected. Limit regular kills. I can kill like 4 of them. Oh dear, someone is already noticing me. Let's hide down here maybe. I swear, if you come too close, I will have to kill you. Well, so much for not being detected. Seriously, I was out of cover for like 2 seconds and they already noticed me. And I can't assassinate him from this angle, I'm afraid. Alright. So, now that I failed that objective, let's try this again. The problem is, once Connor is seen, like even a glimpse of Connor, he's not going back into cover in the bushes. He's just staying outside of them. And that's definitely something that is different from previous Assassin's Creed games, where you could still like go back into hiding if, you know, they spotted you for just a short moment. Anyway, let's see how we can get closer to Pitcairn. I mean, I'm supposed to air assassinate him, but he would have to be like near a tree or whatever if I want to do that. And here we go again. That was not a good idea, I think. And Pitcairn ran away. This is a difficult mission. This is really difficult. So I should take greater precautions and try not to get detected. Okay. So I hope I will be able to kill this guy without everyone else noticing it. Alright. That's one person less, but I can only kill four of them. So, I mean, if I want to air assassinate him, I have to get higher, like on a tree, for example. So the game must have some method to achieve that. So let me try to find some trees I can climb. Well, again, I may have to kill this guy. There we go. I do see a few trees over here, so maybe these are trees I can climb. And I would like to get into that card over here. Alright. So, is that him? I suppose that's him. He's not really near any tree though, so I'm not sure how this would work, but since it's the game's preferred method, there must be a way to do this. For example, maybe if I go through here and climb that tree over here. That seems like my best option at the moment. But we do have another guy in this little camp over here, right? Yeah, I may have to kill him as well, but he's basically on his own, so if I kill him, no one else should notice, I hope. So let's try to draw him over here and kill him. Okay. This is going a bit better. Yeah, I guess I'm supposed to climb up this tree over here. Well, if Connor would actually do it. There we go. Um, Well, he's too far away for an air assassination. I guess I have to be on that tree? Can I just jump over there? I'm not sure, honestly. That seems very far. And I'm afraid that they will notice me if I do this. Okay. I can climb onto this one. Here we go. He's still too far away. I don't know, can I jump onto that flagpole? I mean, that's the only high thing in the vicinity of Pitcairn, right? So, I don't know. Well, he's not really moving any closer though. All right, I can jump onto this and here we go. Perfect assassination.
Why? Why did you do this?
To protect Adams and Hancock and those they serve. You meant to kill them.
Kill them? Are you mad? I wanted only to parley. There was so much to discuss. To explain. You've put an end to that now.
If you speak true, then I will carry your last words to them.
They must lay down their arms. They must stop this war.
Why them and not the Redcoats?
Do you not think we ask the same question of the British? These things take time. And it would have succeeded had you let me play my part.
Part of the puppeteer.
For better we hold the strings than another.
No, the strings should be severed. All should be free.
And we should live forever on castles in the sky. You wield your blade like a man, but your mouth like a child. And more will die now because of that.
Saha yonere ne o te nam da se takwe. Tini o ne yaho te na tam da se takwe.
So, what did I just take? Some kind of letter? But maybe I should try to escape now, before I do anything else. Oh, I don't actually have to escape. I'm just going into the next cutscene. Okay, works with me.
How dare you sneak up on me like that? Why don't you just go out there and just help this camp retreat? Don't ever do that again, you hear me? God damn it!
He's always so angry.
General Putnam.
You live.
The same cannot be said for Pitcairn.
Well done, I suppose. But it matters little now. I'm ordering a full retreat. We have lost too many in exchange for too little. If the Tories want this hill so badly, let them have it. Boston is the true prize.
Huh. So basically, this was all in vain.
We have a bigger problem.
What do you mean?
This can't be right. It says they plan to murder Washington.
Okay. Well, I guess we have to stop that from happening.
My enemy is tenacious. When money failed them, they took to force. But I have slain Johnson and Pitcairn both, ending their plots. George Washington now rallies the colonists, and their march towards freedom begins in earnest. Little wonder, then, that the Templars now want him dead. They seek to reshape this land into something cold and ordered, something soulless. And he is an obstacle. I must save him, that his cause can flourish and my people remain safe. But the more I prod, the greater the chance I am discovered. The Templars believe their men lost the revolution. In their eyes, the assassins are gone and scattered, no longer a threat. But I fear they will soon discover the truth, and me along with it. I must tread carefully.
How fares the hunt, Connor?
There is progress, but I worry it is not enough.
You must strike where you need it most. What if you pursued Charles Lee and your father? What then of Paul Revere and the soldiers at Lexington?
Soldiers? There were no soldiers in those towns, only men and women who were forced to defend themselves.
Is this not why you fight? To protect your people? Your struggle is the colonists' struggle. In helping one, you help the other.
If it only was so easy.
Encouraging words from one who thought mine a fool's errand.
Make no mistake. I still do. But I can't help but feel some pride in your success.
And why should I give you any credit?
Then don't. But first, return the robe and the blade and the darts and all of the years of training and knowledge I have bestowed upon you.
Good point.
Return these, and then your words may have some merit.
Or you could just admit that you are wrong.
Oh, child, please, you've killed two men. One more salesman than soldier. You're gonna have to try a lot harder than that to impress me.
Is that so, old man? Or perhaps we should step outside. I will gladly demonstrate how easily I could trounce.
Connor, this is Benjamin Talmadge. His father was one of us, no need for secrecy. I think he has something he wants to say.
Achilles tells me you've uncovered a plot to murder the commander-in-chief.
Yes, but I have only false starts and dead ends to show for it.
Not anymore, my friend. Thomas Hickey's your man, and I aim to help you catch him.
How?
I'll explain on the way. You and I are going to New York.
Ooh, we're going to New York. However, I'm not going to do this now or in the next episode, because since I just finished a sequence, I'm pretty sure I unlocked more homestead missions. Plus, I still want to leave the animus to read my mails and talk to the people and maybe read some codex entries. So there's a lot of stuff to do before we continue with our next target. But yeah, I think this episode is long enough now, so let's call it a day. As usual, thank you for watching and see you again next time.